Hey, what's up everybody? This is GeekyAviseq once again from here in Dallas, Texas. And today I'm bringing you a quick review of the Oneplus Nord Series N100 phone. So right now you can buy this unlocked from Oneplus for $149, which is actually cheaper than the launch price, which was about $179 when they first launched it a few weeks back here in the US. I was able to get my hands on one of these phones, and if you are in the market for a mid-range cheaper phone, you might be wondering if this phone is worth your purchase or not. Then hopefully this video will help you decide on that. So let's go ahead and take a look what comes in the box. So typical to OnePlus, you get this USB-A to USB-C red charging cable. You also get a fast charger, but this is only 18 watts versus the 30 watt that you get on the more expensive, the OnePlus N10 series phone. Now there's also some manuals and paperwork and the SIM ejector tool here, no case included. And then finally what you get is the phone. Let's take a quick look from on the phone from the different angles so that you guys can see how the phone looks like. So you have this matte plastic back, you have triple camera setup, then fingerprint scanner. Even though this is matte black, I mean matte finish, which they are calling it as the color as midnight frost, it can actually, it gets smudged very easily. As you can see, I just took the phone out of the box and played with it a few times. I've already wiped it, but boom, the fingerprints are back again. Let's go ahead and see on the sides. You get your power button on the top, you get your secondary microphone on the left, you get your SIM card tray. It also has a micro SD card slot, and then the volume rocker on the bottom. You get your 3.5mm audio jack, then the microphone, USB-C, and one the stereo speakers. This phone, they don't say it's stereo, but this phone does have dual speakers. So let me try to focus on the top of the screen so you can see the speaker grill on the top. It does have a hole punch camera, and you know, the first thing that you would notice when you turn the phone on is probably the big chin, which tells you that this is a mid-range phone and it's not a flagship. Now let's take a quick look at the specifications. In terms of the display size, it's 6.52 inches 720 or HD IPS LCD at 269 PPI. It is fortunately a high refresh display, so you get 90 Hertz. It's Corning Gorilla Glass 3. In terms of processing power, it's powered by the Qualcomm Snapdragon 460 with the Adreno 610 as the GPU. 4 GB of RAM, 64 GB of internal storage, which is also expandable up to 256 GB. In terms of battery, it has a 5000 mAh battery, and you get an 18 watt fast charger included in the box. In terms of camera specs, you only get like a 13 megapixel main shooter, and then you get a 2 megapixel macro sensor and 2 megapixel bokeh sensor, or your portrait mode camera. In terms of shooting video capabilities, it can only shoot up to 1080p at 30 frames per second. The front camera can only do 720p at 30 frames per second. Now, it is running Android 10 Oxygen OS, which is OnePlus's customized version of almost close to plain vanilla stock Android. And then you get Bluetooth 5.0. And you don't get any NFC in this phone. So basically, in Flossie Carter's way of saying, mid-range specs, bro, mid-range specs. There's nothing super impressive in terms of the specs on this phone. Now, the first thing that you would notice when you pick up the phone is basically the build quality and the display. So, but this is an LCD screen, so definitely lacking some of the brightness, lacking some of the color saturation, you know, deeper blacks and all that. But if you're coming from an older phone, maybe even if you're coming from an older iPhone from 6 to 8, you will feel right at home because the display quality are, you know, very similar to that. Now, obviously for the price, for $150, you cannot expect any more. And it does have 90 hertz, so I think it's pretty acceptable for OnePlus to actually be able to give you know, a 90 hertz display on a $150 phone. Then definitely the, you know, thicker chin at the bottom, which is kind of an eyesore. I prefer the phone to have a more symmetrical design. I don't mind if the, you know, they would have distributed the space between top and bottom, but unfortunately it's just a tad ugly for me. But again, individual preferences. And then in terms of build quality and all, this phone does feel light, but definitely not at so light that it feels like cheap. It has still has a nice heft to it, and I think OnePlus did a good job in, you know, at least making this phone not feel cheap at $150 price range. So OnePlus did cut some corners, so they did some compromises. Even though this phone has a triple camera setup, the bokeh or the portrait mode camera as well as the macro mode camera, I don't think they are usable at all. At 2 megapixels, I would rather use the primary shooter and crop that if I need a macro shot. And then if I need a portrait shot, I mean, I would just use, I would just use the main camera. Now in terms of camera performance, I would say I wasn't really impressed. I wasn't expecting a lot for $150, but you know, OnePlus has always known to be, even though they don't make the best camera phones, but they had always known to make a very decent camera performance for the price. But that kind of factor or DNA is missing in this phone. I would say the camera on in good lighting conditions, the images that you take is very usable, but not probably be good enough for social media uploads. But it's not going to be something that I would, you know, would use this phone to capture some important moments of my life or anything like that. It's just, it's not super trashy. It's not like a VGA camera, but you can, I mean, once you look at the images, you can definitely tell that this is not like, you know, it's not shot from a, you know, flagship device or not even a mid-ranger. The quality of the images are kind of just okay-ish. Now let's talk about the performance. So Snapdragon 460, so don't expect, you know, super performance. If you are playing a lot of games, then this is not the phone for you. But if you are a casual user and if you play some games, then you would do just fine. And what else can you expect from a $150 phone? So for that, if you keep the price tag in mind, I think this phone is decent when it comes to performance. I didn't see any major lags or slowdowns. But when I was playing some high demanding games, definitely the experience was the experience was just okay, but it would be not some phone that I would want to play games all the time with. But if you are not a gamer and you just want to use this phone as a phone for regular social media, browsing, calling, texting, I think you should be good. Also, the battery life is pretty good with the included 5000 mAh battery, and even with the 18 watts charger, the phone charges up pretty fast. So now time for final conclusions and my recommendations. I would say if I was to buy a phone for $150, I would actually skip this one and save that money and save up more to probably get a better phone. And I would totally skip that. But you know, if you are absolutely in a bind, you just have $150 and you have no other options, then you know, and then you can buy this, because the UI performance, battery life is good, but the camera performance is absolutely trash. And then in terms of, you know, gaming performance, the performance is not that great. And then the display is, you know, 720p and then has a very thick bezel. I know it's a $150 phone, but I would rather buy an older flagship, even a used one, for that much money or a little bit more. And I think that phone will give you a better performance, better overall experience compared to this one. So I would say I didn't like this phone. It's just more, I mean, it's an okay phone. It's not absolute trash. But personally, me, I cannot recommend this phone. So that's all, guys. That's pretty much everything for this video. If you like my video, don't forget to hit the like button. Also, don't forget to share it with your friends and ask them to subscribe. If they have not subscribed, you should also subscribe if you haven't. And if you want to be notified for whenever I upload a new video, don't forget to hit the bell icon. Also, stay healthy, stay safe, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Till then, bye.